Vectorman was a platform shooter released for the Sega Genesis by Blue Sky in 1995. It takes place in the year 2049. The planet Earth has turned into a shithole due to all the pollution, so all humans are sent to other planets while these robots made out of orbs called Orbots clean everything up. One of the supervisor Orbots, Raster, accidentally gets a nuclear bomb attached to his control circuits. He goes apeshit and becomes Warhead, declaring himself the ruler of Earth, threatening to kill any human who dares to return. Vectorman, who is unaffected by the control of Warhead because he was delivering sludge to the sun during the hostile takeover, returns to Earth to discover the chaotic situation and acts as a vigilante to restore peace to the world. So you play as Vectorman, as you might have guessed, and run through 16 levels which are broken off into days. You go around blasting shit and collecting power-ups, a lot of which are hidden in these monitors that you have to blast apart to get to. These power-ups include upgrades for your gun, health balls, checkpoints, extra lives, bonus time, as well as various temporary transformations. There are three difficulty settings. Lame is easy, wicked is normal, and insane is difficult. These settings determine how much damage enemies can take, as well as how many hit points you start out with. 3, 4, or 5. You can find power-ups to increase your maximum health points as well. You find these floating, flashy star things called photons, which give you points. The gun upgrades consist of a rapid-fire shot that can ricochet off walls, a spread shot, and a shot that swirls in circles and can go through enemies. You can also get a bomb that'll wipe out all enemies on the screen when triggered, as well as a shield that'll protect you temporarily. The transformations I mentioned earlier will give you temporary abilities. They include a drill that'll tear through a particular type of floor, a missile that'll break through the ceiling, a cart that'll break through walls, a bomb that'll blow up walls and enemies in the surrounding area, the ability to swim, the ability to fly, and a parachute that'll slow down your fall. You can also slow yourself down in midair by firing down. While standing on the ground, however, you won't be able to fire down, but you can fire in 5 directions, including diagonally. Another cool ability is the double jump. While in midair, pressing jump again will trigger the jet streams in your feet to send you up again, which will help you get to hard-to-reach areas or avoid collision with an enemy. All in all, the controls are tight. Even more impressive are the graphics. Fluid animations, slick backgrounds, and beautifully rendered 3D models are absolutely stunning for the time. But great graphics don't necessarily make a great game. The gameplay has to count, too. And Vectorman doesn't disappoint in this category either. It's fun and challenging no matter what difficulty setting you use, especially since there are no continues, my friend. So beating this game is an accomplishment. Even if you cheat and use the skip level code, you won't be awarded with the ending. The game itself will tell you to go back and finish it like a man. The soundtrack is also done well. It incorporates techno-electronic based beats, which is very fitting, but the composer does a great job of keeping the songs different from each other, which isn't easy to do with this genre. The level design is also very creative. While most stages are side-scrollers, there are a few that are overhead and done very differently. They're a lot shorter and almost resemble a bonus stage, but this mixes it up a little bit, though the side-scrolling levels aren't monotonous by any means. Before you even get to the title screen, you can actually start playing. At the Sega logo screen, Vectorman drops down and you can control him, run, jump, shoot, get used to the controls, or basically just fuck around for the hell of it. There's even an Easter egg on the screen. If you shoot upwards, you can destroy a monitor that'll freeze up the trippy background. So once you're done screwing around, decide on your options and start the game. These Orbots will fire small projectiles or try to smash you if you get up close. So keep a safe distance and duck underneath its attacks while firing to get them out of your way. They're a real common enemy throughout the game, so get used to them. You'll also want to get used to these fucking mosquitoes that hover around in schools that aren't that easy to see. So if you spot some commotion, it's probably these bastards flying around. Stop, shoot up, and don't stop until there's no more moving around up there. Take out every monitor you see, grabbing the photons, health power-ups, and checkpoints. One of the ones you'll see right at the beginning will award you with a spread shot power-up. Keep in mind that all these gun upgrades only last a limited amount of time. Shortly after getting this gun, there's a secret little nook you can jump into if you time your jump right. It'll lead to a checkpoint on the right side and a bomb right near the wall which you can take out. There are invisible platforms here. Use the floating photons as a guide and follow them. It'll lead to 3 monitors. Take out the ones on the sides first to get the extra lives, and then the middle one to turn into the jet which you can use to bypass a lot of the level. Toward the end here, there are a couple little nooks on the right side where you can get a couple of health balls if you need them before the boss battle with this plane. It'll fly back and forth and drop bombs here and there, but the only real threat are the two metal balls that are suspended by either side. Stay in between them and fire upwards continuously, preferably staying away from being directly underneath. Keep hitting it when the hatches are open and you'll take it down easily. The second stage is extremely short. You've taken form of a train, and this big-ass robot metalhead will try to keep up with you by grabbing onto the tracks. You'll be in continuous auto-scroll type motion, although you can control whether you pick up or reduce speed with the directional buttons while these projectile shits come at you from the sides. Fire straight ahead most of the time to force metalhead to fall, although he'll regain his grip a few times. You can also shoot at the sides to take out the projectiles if they get too close. Jump over his hands when you get too close to them, and continue firing until he falls for the last time, and that's the end of the stage. Level 3 is a pretty flat water stage. The enemies consist mostly of these guns, a school of scuba tanks that you can duck under if you're patient enough to wait and not just blast them, and these brown shits that don't do anything and hope you just run into them. So you'll want to stay at a steady pace here. These small platforms will pop up here and there. A lot of times a monitor will be around, so hop on them to grab some bonuses. After this long platform, slip down and get to the fish transformation. You'll be able to swim throughout the level and plow through everything without taking damage. Right after that, you can get a bomb, which can blow up this wall here that leads you to a kill-all attack that you can trigger whenever you like. No boss in this stage, just a few more enemies and you're clear. The fourth stage takes place underwater, and you'll be moving slower because of it. You're constantly scaling upward from platform to platform, killing off some of the same enemies you met in the previous level. You have 7 minutes to get through, so there's no need to rush it. For the beginning and the middle portion, there's a fish adapter which can speed up the process a bit, but first you'll want to head left. Along the sidelines are these little crannies that have photons and sometimes secret passageways. The first one is here, so you'll want to get the rapid fire shot before you start swimming. The next one is on the right side where you can get a shield. And on the left side is another passageway where you can max out your health and add a hit point. Not long after that is a rocket transformation that'll directly take you to the boss, and it has two forms. The first one is this robotic buzzard or some shit. It'll fly back and forth and fire ahead of itself, so your best bet is to follow it from behind. It doesn't even stand a chance as long as you get up close to the edge of the screen each time it passes by. The second form is a robotic polar bear, who will walk slowly and fire a projectile, which can easily counter by jumping behind him and shooting him in the ass. He'll stand up and fire a three-way spread shot, but again, you can easily jump over him and attack him from behind with his gun. In the beginning of level 5, go down the first drop and left to get a rapid shot if you want. Then take out this monitor to turn into a drill. Take out the floor here and get the swirl gun. The enemies you'll encounter are mostly these walking robots that aren't too hard to kill, as long as you give yourself some space because they attack you at close range. Then later on, here's another drill. Go backward a bit to tear the floor down and grab a full health ball. There's a little hidden area to sneak into here to get a shield, and right after that is a checkpoint. Head up to get this spread shot and get ready for this mini-boss battle of sorts. This large robot will stand in one spot and lunge at you if you get too close, but you can't jump over him because he'll jump up with you. His face shields off your attacks, but if you shoot at his tail, it'll fall off. Then you can get over him because he can't jump anymore, and shoot him from behind as it's the only way to kill him. He'll turn around, but you can jump back and repeat the process. Or you can just say fuck it and move on once you get over him. He's not a boss, so you don't need to kill him. There is no boss either, and the end of the stage is just ahead. There is a bonus round, though. You can get there by grabbing the shield and destroying the satellite dish that you'll find toward the end. There are a few in other levels, too, but all of them are the same, and it only awards you points, which really isn't all that useful. Basically, just fire in the direction where these missiles come from, and this thing that spins around you, drawing its way closer. Your objective is to just survive for 1 minute for a 25,000 point bonus. Again, there's no need to even bother. Stage 6 is the bamboo mill, and most of the level takes place on these pulleys that are pulled side to side or up and down. You can ride them up or down on these buckets to go to alternate paths. Head up on the first one that you can and head left to turn into a bomb. Blow up the wall and find yourself an extra life. When you head out, jump your way to the highest point you can. Find the drill and tear through the floor to get a full health ball. Head up the line of buckets and shoot this monitor like so to get yourself a rapid shot. When you reach this area with a wooden plank by the ceiling, jump up and through it. Shoot your way through everything and take the highest path you can. Stop right before this fall and grab the checkpoint before you fight this boss called Clockwork. It can be a pain in the ass. It'll wheel its way towards you. Shoot at it and it'll start a pinata explosion of harmful shit. Keep a long enough distance to avoid all this, but you'll want to be close enough to connect with its head. You also don't want to get too far away because it'll move towards you kind of fast, and if you try to jump over it, it'll start its explosion attack right under you and you'll probably get tagged. Be nimble and nifty and you'll finish him off.